Hello, Lottie Rogerson. It's lovely to have you on She Can. Tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do.
Thank you, Stephanie. It's so lovely of you to invite me to be in this series of videos for your websites. I feel very honoured. So I, alongside my husband, run Cottesmore Prep School, which is a pre-prep and prep school on the border of Surrey and Sussex. And we've been doing that for, this is the end, coming to the end of our 13th year, if we can quite believe that. And yeah, we have about 200 children in the school. In the prep school, the majority of them are full boarders, so they're here 24/7. And we live in the building. So where I'm sitting at the moment is our sitting room. And just outside are the girls' dormitories. And above us are the girls' dormitories. So I can hear everything, which is great fun. It's great fun. So you couldn't do this job if you didn't love it.
Absolutely. And you do it with a lot of passion, and the children are so happy. Lottie, tell us a little bit how you got to this. How was your journey? What did you study? How did you get to what you do today?
So I went to a prep school in Oxford, and then I went to an all-girls boarding school myself. And then actually I went and studied history of art and architecture at Manchester, which I loved, but very quickly realized that I wasn't able to probably survive with the amount of money that people were paid in the art world. So I went and did a postgraduate degree in education at the Institute of Education in London, and then went into teaching from there, and went to go and teach in a little pre-prep in London, which is there when I met my husband. He was also teaching in the same school. So I taught there for 5 years. I taught year one, and then we moved out to the countryside, and we were teaching in boarding schools then. And then Tom got a call from his father asking us to come and take over Cottesmore in 2008. And we've been doing it ever since.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing, Lottie. I mean, what is it like to work so closely with your husband?
Yeah, there are times, but actually it's very good. I think to begin with, it was an interesting, because literally we came off the back of our honeymoon straight into this job. And it's taken us a while, a fair few years, to actually work out where we're best placed and how we work well together. So I've actually stepped back from teaching. When I first arrived, I taught the younger years in the prep school. And then I set up the pre-prep a year into us being here. And I started all of that. And now it's very much, Tom and I have worked out that he is very good at being the wonderful headmaster who's out there front facing and, you know, making great videos and taking the boys and girls fishing and all of that. And I'm much better at sort of just making sure that everything is running smoothly. I mean, I love being with the kids, obviously, but the paperwork side of things is much more sort of where it falls in my lap, so, which is fine, and I enjoy it.
And you do it so well, Lottie. what motivates you, you know, every morning to do it?
Gosh, well, I suppose being a mum, you know, you often, I mean, my boys are still quite small, so my youngest is 4, and then my eldest is 8, and so mornings you don't, and actually Alandra's got a puppy, so I don't get mornings. I literally just got to start having mornings again, and now I don't have them because I now have a puppy. But I think the fact that this is Tom's family school, you know, his father was headmaster, his grandfather, and I'm sure when you actually get to, you know, fully experience it, you will understand that it is the Rogerson sort of seep through the building, and it makes me very proud to be married into this family that sort of holds such emotions towards this building and this school. And when we first arrived, the numbers weren't great. We'd had an interim headmaster between Tom's father and us, and things had slightly slipped. So when we actually started, we only had 90 children in the whole building. And then at the moment, come September, we'll be 200. So it's been an upward battle, but just making sure that the children are happy, I think, is the main thing. And certainly for my boarders, and this year in particular, because so many of them have had such ups and downs with, you know, lockdown and flying home and online learning, you know, it's been very tricky. And I've got some children that actually haven't been home since the summer, you know, and so that pastoral side of it, where I am actually their residential mum, is really, really important. And I need to know that they're feeling happy and safe and looked after. At the same time, so are my staff, because they've also had, you know, we all suddenly last year got thrown into this whole thing of online learning, which nobody had ever done before. And we, all of us, from, you know, the younger lot, who obviously they find it much easier, to the older generation of my teachers, you know, they really had to come full circle and get to grips with it. And so, you know, doing that whole making sure that everyone was okay and feeling secure in themselves has been, you know, a really big, important thing for us this year, and especially for me. And acknowledging the fact that it has been tricky for everyone, you know, in the teaching profession, we've been very lucky. No one's been furloughed or been made redundant, you know, because we're all very much still needed. But there's still sort of, I suppose, uncertainty with everything at the moment.
Yeah.
And it's just ensuring and making sure that everybody is comfortable, you know, from everyone, from my cleaner to my husband. So
Lottie, you're holding so many strings. Very impressive. Thank you for sharing that. I think, tell us, what do you think is your superpower to handle all of that? What do you have that makes you successful in what you do?
Gosh, I don't know. I quite like to bottle it if I did. I don't know. I suppose organization, I think. My mother is ridiculously organized and makes lists of lists. So, and forward planning. He finds it quite amusing. If I know that I'm going to do something, I will prepare and look forward to know what I'm doing. Whereas he'll just get in the car and just go and just work it out when he got there. So it's just knowing what's happening, I suppose, and then trying to plan to the eventualities that might occur at that time. Obviously you can't plan everything, but trying to be prepared as much as one can be, I suppose, is my superpower.
I think that's a very female superpower. Yeah,
I think it is. You know, it's just the multitasking, which clearly, as we know, women are awesome at. And I think listening is really key, you know, spending time and listening to, you know, little Johnny and the fact that he found a frog, or, you know, Mrs. Miggins and the fact that, you know, she's got a sore knee. You know, you've got to be able to have a very, very strong listening ear and realizing that everybody needs a bit of your time. And if you get cross at that, it's never going to work. You've got to be able to find that 2 minutes of your time and just go, do you know what? Those emails can wait. Nothing's going to happen.
Yeah.
It's their time. They want a little bit of me, and that's what I'm going to give them home. Yeah.
I think that's universal. Yeah. I think everyone sort of needs to be heard, especially little people. Yeah.
Absolutely. I think, you know, that's one thing that women are very good at. You know, and I've certainly learned that some sort of like women that I've worked with and my friends that I was at school with, you know, it's just, if you're having a bad day, you know, that solidarity that we have as women is the thing I think that gets me through, you know, the tough times and the good times, you know, but I still have a very great 4 of my best girlfriends from boarding school. And, you know, that we're in far flung places. One lives in Kenya, you know, they're all across the UK, yet we speak almost daily, you know, from everything from, you know, the dog won't stop doing this at home, you know, to, you know, here's my glass of wine, and someone sends a photo of their glass of wine. But it's just knowing that you have that team behind you as a woman, because often we are, you know, we're the mums, we're the working person, we're the cook, we're the cleaner, you know, we're the washerwoman, we're the taxi driver. But if you have a core group of girls, as I, you know, it helps you get through, you know, the day, I think.
Absolutely. I think that's so true. Lottie, what would your top tips be for other women?
Gosh, my top tips. I think it's just one, find time for yourself. That is one thing that I'm still learning to do. Like I was saying, we do, most women do everything. You know, we have 100 jobs, whether you actually have a job where you go to an office, you're still doing 100 jobs at home and for your family. But it's really key that you go and do something for yourself, whether it's walking a dog, going to the gym, going for a swim, doing some cooking, just zone yourself into you. And I think that's one thing I've found this year, especially when the world, you know, did actually slow down. And I think it made us all realize, you know, that it was important to have some me time. And also, I think it's acknowledge everyone. Make sure that everyone around you feels as special as you would like to feel yourself. You know, and know that you can do anything. It doesn't matter who you are, where you come from. You know, if you want to do something, go and do it. You know, it might be a hard climb, but you know, you will get to the top. You just might have to traverse a bit to get there.
Yes, I agree with that completely. Lottie, one last question. What, I mean, in 5 years' time, what would your dream be
dream or my reality dream?
Well, either.
I have two.
Well, then you name them both.
Okay, so my dream would be where I actually changed professions entirely. And I would be a marine biologist, and I'd be living in the Florida Keys and going and doing wonderful things underwater. That's my dream. But my reality dream is, I think the fact that I think just keep on doing what we're doing. Tom and I are so happy with what we're doing, and I actually feel quite proud how far we've come. I'd maybe like to take my foot off the gas a little bit and find some of that me time a bit more. But essentially, if you love what you do, then essentially you are living your dream, which I feel very privileged to be doing at the moment.
Amazing. Lottie, thank you so much for sharing your story.
Not at all. Thank you for asking.